Tiny, but potentially deadly. They look pretty harmless. Here's one here. They're called button batteries, and they're easily eaten by children, and sometimes they can even kill them.
In a mission to save lives around the world, a bright spark from Wellington has found a potential solution, and it's getting international attention. Aaron Somer has more.
It was a standard lunchtime, child's play, in this Auckland household.
Okay, go play now.
But watching a kid's every move is easier said than done. Vanya got her hands on a button battery, which parents Prerna and Manoj had earlier hidden.
When I looked at her, she was making that gagging sound, like that something is stuck. Then we went straight to the hospital, and then she went in for the surgery to get the thing out, and she was, I think, in the hospital for about 1 week.
Yeah, it was a bit hard, yeah, very hard time. So like they said, it may have left some kind of the burns inside.
Of course, I was pretty scared.
Button battery injuries are well documented. This BBC experiment uses ham to represent a child's throat.
So we can see the chemical reaction that happens.
In Auckland's Starship Hospital alone, 20 kids are admitted each year with button battery injuries. But in a lab in Wellington, there's a superhero of sorts. Industrial design guru Jongbin Ok is working to save lives.
That'll be great. That was a dream.
That dream, his light bulb moment, involves tomato ketchup.
One day, while I was walking down the street, I saw a boy with his mouth area stained with something red stuff, probably tomato ketchup or something. What if I add something to the battery? And if it stains the oral area, then it could give a visual alert to the caregivers.
And so, alongside a colleague,
I think we'll need to tweak the viscosity.
He's on the cusp of success with a dye that makes kids spit batteries out instead of swallowing them.
So, Jongbin, you tried different colours and you didn't go for red. Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Well, it's like blood. It's quite traumatizing. And also from the parents' point of view, it's a really shocking scene.
They chose blue, and after trialling 500 different formulas, they think they've got it right.
Sorry, Mum. Is that enough?
No, I have some now. Maybe.
Jongbin's manners are much better than mine.
I can show you here.
The edible dye is mixed with a salivation agent and a cocktail of feral flavourings.
The mix of bitter, hot, spicy, salty,
disgusting.
And disgusting.
The potentially life-saving solution is so revolutionary. Woo! Battery giant Energizer caught wind of it and started moves to conduct human trials in the US.
We'd like to see some intervention from the government and regulators, because it is quite hard to just rely on goodwill of manufacturers. Manufacturers are basically wanting to make more money.
If it has international applications, as it absolutely looks like it does, it'd be fantastic to see it go across the world. It's Kiwi innovation at its best.
It should help save lives of children.
Every time we faced like a very difficult situation, we always reminded us of the dream.
A life-saving dream to stop a parent's nightmare.
That is so smart. Kids, they stick everything in their mouths.
Yeah.
Did you ever have those panic moments where you just went, what on earth are they stuck in there now?
Yes, luckily my kids didn't choke anything. But once I did actually find my daughter feeding my son pain medication in the cat. That wasn't good.
Rescued that situation, did you?
Yes.
Happy ending?
Whew, okay. Happy ending.